So walkthrough of CUI categorization. So
demo
all
time.
All right. So let's talk about all sorts of fun stuff here. So we are in the National Archives, just like the what we had talked about previously. We're going to scroll down to the CUI category list. Again, some of these screenshots you've already seen. Scroll on down here. We have the list of all of those, what they call organizational index groupings, and then the CUI categories underneath. And so one of the great examples we like to talk about is defense and controlled technical information. So let's jump into that for a second. So we can see this category description, and it's a long category description. It's basically saying, hey, this is what CTI is. Here's the reference documentation. DFARS 7013 has the definition, all this great stuff. And it kind of sounds like, hey, everything might be CUI that's technology, right? It's kind of a broad stroke there. But if we look down a little bit, we can tell different things like the category markings when you're marking CUI. And all the way down at the very bottom is the safeguarding or dissemination authority. So this is what's actually going to tell us the reference document, right? Of, hey, what's in here? And does it apply to us, right? So it tells us if it's basic or specified CUI. And then it gives us, again, the banner marking that we're going to need for that. So I'm going to crack open our tried and true DFARS 7012 here. Zoom in a little bit for you here. So as you're reading through this, you see different kind of references to contractor system, contractor managed system, right? Non-federal systems, so forth and so on. So this is where it starts calling out where this clause, if you will apply to you, right? These are the types of systems that you need. This is how you need to configure them. This is the type of a cloud environment you need to use, all wrapped up in this document. So for the sake of this, following the CUI, I'm going to pull up contractor technical information because that's what I clicked on. And you can see the definition here. Controlled technical information means technical information with military or space application that is subject to controls on the access, use, reproduction, et cetera. I won't read all of that. It even goes into things like distribution statements that you might see coming from the DoD that contractors can actually see. So poses another great question, right? It's like, okay, well, I get the word controlled. It's control it. But technical information, is there a better definition of what that is? So if I scroll over here to that same clause, it actually defines technical information. Means technical data or computer software as those terms are defined in the clause DFARS 252-227-7013. And if you look at what that clause is called, rights and technical data for non-commercial items.
Non-COTS.
Non-COTS. Does this apply to consumer off-the-shelf items I can go to Walmart and pick up?
No.
It does not. If I'm selling pencils to the DoD, does it matter?
No.
Right. So let's crack open this clause. So as you're going through here, and you can tell I rehearsed this with my purple links here. As you can tell, this actually didn't switch tabs for me. There we go.
There we go.
If you pull this up, Aquisition.gov, rights and technical data management, it actually goes through definitions of computer database, right? Computer program, computer software. And this is what, again, helps you refine and understand is what you're doing actually going to be CUI, or in this case, controlled technical information, right? So doing this level of due diligence, talking to your prime, talking to your contracting officer at the DoD level or subs above you to have a really kind of good understanding of, okay, is what we're doing CUI or CTI? Or more important, and more importantly, if I'm distributing this information to other subs, do I need to be sending them this whole document, right? So I'm going to give you an example of that. So I was on a call last week or maybe a couple weeks ago, and they called me and they said, hey, we're about 500 people. We just turn and burn. We make consumer off-the-shelf parts, right? And we do that all the time. Well, we have a couple of prime contractors that we work with to deliver services or goods. I was like, okay, great. But they keep sending us all of these drawings that are marked every which way. ITAR, export control, CTI, CUI. But the part that we're delivering is not. It's a consumer off the shelf. So what do we need to do there, right? And so one of the most important things there was talk to your contracting officer. Tell them, give them a database or give them an understanding of, hey, this is the crosswalk of here's what you're asking for. Here's our part. just tell us you need this part, right? It's a consumer off the shelf part. We don't want your ITAR drawings. We have nowhere to protect it.
Yeah, because then it puts them at risk.
That's right.
Right.
They just want to know transactionally, I need this gizmo. And you just tell me you need that gizmo. That's again, consumer off the shelf. And then they just ship 1,000 units over to you.
Right.
So help protect your supply chain. Don't overburden your supply chain, because we see a lot of that going on these days where we're just seeing perpetual flow down of the DFARS clauses, even for companies that don't do any kind of CUI related work. They're not manufacturing anything that is controlled unclassified information. So.
Right.
Anyways, that's a little shout out, little soapbox for me. Primes, do a little bit better. DOD, please do a little bit better. Help protect your supply chain.